Hello, I'm Dr. Randy Dozier. I'm bringing you news about graduation for this senior class 2020. Governor McMaster's most recent executive order encouraged some form of high school graduation ceremony, whether it was in person or virtual. We made a decision last week to actually have an in-person ceremony with some limitations. We will follow the social distancing guidelines that the State Department gave to all high schools across the state. I would ask, as you consider graduation, that if you exhibit any signs of illness, that you would not attend the graduation ceremony. Graduation seniors will only receive two tickets in trying to limit the size of the crowds. I've asked that graduates, along with the public, wear a face mask during the ceremony. Of course, that's recommended. It's certainly up to you. Certainly, you take those off as you walk across the stage. Seating must maintain the recommended 6 feet distance between the attendees. Stadium seats will be clearly marked, and specific areas will be assigned for standing. We will have, at all the stadiums, designated additional car parking for graduate families surrounding the stadium in a limited number. See your principal if you're interested in staying and remaining in your car. The principal will issue designated parking passes. Again, we will maintain social distances. We will probably enter the stadium in small groups with separation. We'll have this usual screening that we typically always have with security, with the metal detectors, but also we'll have our school nurses at the gates checking for wellness, doing wellness checks. We will not check temperatures. I would ask that you do that before you come, much like we do almost daily now, to check your temperature before you go out. Our resource officers will be there, law enforcement and teachers will be there. We'll have restrooms available with attendees at all the restrooms, assisting the public as they come and go. The event will be live streamed for maximum participation via Facebook, and hopefully we'll have FM radio or AM radio at all the stadiums. Diplomas will be picked up by the graduate on the table to eliminate person-to-person contact. And this is really important. I need your help with this. After the ceremony, please exit the stadium in an orderly fashion, maintaining your distance, and please disperse as quickly as possible. Hold the celebrations till later after you exit the campus. So here's the schedule for the graduation. Howard Adult Education will go first on Thursday, May 28 at 9 a.m. at Georgetown High School Stadium. Carvers Bay High School, Monday, June 1st at 9 a.m. Andrews High School, Tuesday, June 2nd at 9 a.m. Georgetown High School, Wednesday, June 3rd at 9 a.m. And Waccamaw High School, Thursday, June 4th at 9 a.m. We do have rain dates available, June 5th and 6th, same time at 9 a.m. However, we're going to treat this graduation much like an athletic event, a football game. If it rains, we may have a weather delay. We'd ask you to remain in your cars till called, but we'll make that announcement. The reason why we only are having one graduation a day is it's very labor intensive and time intensive, and it's about all we can manage in a day. We have to have the resources and the people there to assist with parking and seating and meeting all these limitations that we typically would have today that we wouldn't have otherwise. So I thank you for your patience and understanding. We know how difficult a time this is, and we want you to know we're working diligently to make this the best possible experience, considering the limitations and restrictions we face. And I would add, in closing, I must add that things are subject to change based on any future mandates by the governor or any future changes with regard to the virus. I really need your help and assistance to make it this graduation ceremony come over without a hitch, and I certainly hope that you'll have a good experience, and I wish you the best, and I look forward to seeing you there. Thank you.